going, guys? Johnny Cisco here, and somewhere a little bit different. As you know, FGW is still looking for a new home, but to make sure you guys still have wrestling content from us in the meantime, we are doing a special set of episodes where we pick some wrestlers and we go over some of their favorite matches. If this is airing on the day that I believe it is, we are only a couple days off from my 1 year anniversary of professional wrestling, so I got lucky and got the first episode. I started wrestling when I heard about Cody's training school from my tattoo artist, and I took the leap. I figured I had nothing else to lose at that point. And fortunately for me, Cody Hawk was an incredible trainer. He was very supportive. He taught me everything I needed to know, how to kick some butt. But unfortunately, the nice training side of him was not there when we stepped in the ring against each other for the first time, for my first match. There was another rough lesson from him, though. A lesson that the real world is not as easy as the practice. And I haven't forgotten that lesson. And that's something I took to heart long term, and something I think you'll see in the match that follows with the graduating class, against Ben Chimera. We all put our heart and soul into that. It took all four of us using everything we learned from Cody, but we finally got the job done, so I think you'll really enjoy that one too.
Opening match tonight is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit from Howell, Michigan, Johnny Cisco.
This radio station was named Audio Slave in honor of the last American hero to whom speed means freedom of the soul. The question is not when it's gonna stop, but who is gonna stop them.
From Malibu Beach, representing the five most wanted, the Icon, Cody Hawk. So here we are again, Friday Night Fury. And the worst of the worst comes out to support FGW. You may love me, but no one loves you, bro. So you know, I'm standing back there all day, and I'm watching guys come in. I'm watching guys getting dressed. I'm watching guys warming up. And I'm thinking to myself, none of these guys want it. None of these guys want to go to the top. None of these guys want to be the best of the best. Well, that's what I want to be. I want to be the best of the best, and I am the best of the best. Starting to see a lot of my new students filtering onto the show. This right here is one of them. And he should be the best of the best. This kid's been training for like 9 or 10 months. You know what? He should have been on shows 4 or 5 months ago, but he didn't want it bad enough. And tonight, he gets to step in the ring with me. I'm going to tell you right now, you better step back before I cut you down. Tonight, you get to go one-on-one with Cody Hawk. And you know what? If you can best me, if you can beat me, hell, if you can even get a shot on me, I might give you an ounce of respect. And then again, I might just beat your ass.
Hello, everybody. Sean Bossman here, the boss of pro wrestling, along with my colleague, J.C. Flash, and you're watching FGW Shockwave. What a great match we got here. Cody Hawk against Johnny Cisco.
Now, Johnny Cisco traveling all the way far across the tracks from Michigan to face Cody Hawk here tonight. Cody Hawk, some strong words for his trainee, Johnny Cisco.
Well, you can't get trained by anybody better than Cody Hawk. I mean, the man makes stars, but you've got to give it your all. He says he doesn't feel that Cisco has really put forth enough effort, like the effort that Cody Hawk put forth when he did that Irish whip. Did you see how much force was behind that?
Lots of velocity, and you know, the proof is in the pudding. Cody Hawk absolutely does train champions. He trained me, and I am the former FGW champion.
Are we really going to go into that again? You had it for what? You know, a blink of an eye? I mean, I didn't even know about it because I sneezed.
How dare you speak illy of my record-breaking reign as Cody Hawk. Hold on, look at this. Look at
Come on, Cody. He used the hair. Obviously, Joe Copez saw that.
Cisco was bringing the fight there for a second.
He certainly was, but a quick handful of hair put a stop to that.
I don't know if the end of this match is going to be all too groovy for Cisco. Oh, did you hear that right hand right to the kidney?
Obviously, the experience advantage is going to go to Cody Hawk. No question about that.
Thanks for clearing that up for us.
Cisco tried to fire back just a little. Uh-oh. Misstep going up on the top rope, the second rope, and he got caught.
And one mistake. Any amount of hesitation, Cody will capitalize just like he did right there.
Absolutely.
Oh, here we go now.
In place for that. Muscle buster. And that's gotta be it. I mean, Copez already looking at, seeing if he can continue.
Well, Sean, I'll say this. It doesn't look great right now if you're Johnny Cisco.
Well, Cody could have pinned him. I mean, what's the point? Oh, that package pile driver.
Oh, wait a minute.
Wait a minute. What?
That's not the package pile driver. Oh, there it is.
Double underhook on top of it.
Cody
making sure it got just a little bit more effect.
Insult to injury, Sean. Insult to injury.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match, the Icon, Cody Hall.
And Sean, you asked what the point was in what Cody just did. I will tell you the point. The point is to make a statement. The point is to back up his words. The point is to remind the FGW fans just how great he is by making easy work of Cisco in this match. It looks like he might not be done.
Oh, come on. Enough's enough. Totally uncalled for. Already made your point, Cody. Obviously, he's making a point to somebody other than... Oh, come on. Can we get some additional help out here?
Yeah, I mean... I mean, I'm all for making a statement, but I can't.
Oh, look at that!
I condone this.
Wow, Cody grab. Oh, wow! Notice how he used the ropes to put a stop to that attack from above.
In rear, and Brian Tuff coming up to save Cisco. He got a package pile driver for his troubles. And how about a muscle buster, Sean?
Another one. Wait a minute, look at that! Sunset flip! This was a match, he may have been able to pin him with that! Nice enziguri kick!
Tornadoed right to the face of Cody Hawk.
Another one of Cody's students. Obviously he has learned quite a bit. As he was ready for Cody's attack. Uh-oh, wait a minute. But he wasn't ready for that.
Cody Hawk dominating every poor soul that he shares that ring with tonight. If I was the referee, I'd watch my back. There's Jacob Rose!
Look at that speed he gave it! On the rope, here he comes again! Back elbow takes Cody down! Double axe handle! And the crowd chanting, Jacob, Jacob! Looks like we're finally putting a stop to this onslaught.
Oh, the shot, he whizzed into the back of the head.
And Cody is finally down.
Jacob Rose just halting Hawk's momentum just like that. And he's not done.
Oh, wait a minute, he turned his back. I wouldn't have done that. Landing on the apron.
Oh no, this isn't good. We've seen this before. That rope on pile driver shot.
How many pile drivers have we seen thus far? I've lost count. Even the fans are saying enough. Oh, wait a minute. Now a chair. Can we get some additional officials, some security?
You know, Cody Hawk, not carrying a briefcase right now, but I assure you, he means business.
We understand that he means business, but he's not going to pile drive him on the chair, is he?
I think he's going to pile drive him on the chair. Yeah, I think that's, yeah, Sean, that chair, that the pile, yeah, it's coming.
Oh, no.
Oh,
no,
here
no.
we go, no.
Oh!
Oh, well, there goes the once promising career.
Ruler. You know whose music that is. That's the music of the Tag Team Champions. Oh, look at that! We're coming from behind! Cody's waiting for him to come down the aisle! Uh-oh!
Oh, and Cody Hawk!
No chance for a cheap shot here!
I think he might have bet his match.
I don't know anybody who can go up against the crown single-handedly.
And at Into the Breeze, Cody Hawk and Sean Casey will face the crown for the Tag Team Championship, Sean.
That's July 1st. Cody is definitely looking to take that Tag Team Championship. If anybody can, it would be Five Most Wanted. But what a match that's going to be.
Absolutely. Crown is dominated, decimated, and annihilated. Everyone that has stood before them ever since they become champion, and really for the longevity of their career here at FCW. And from what I understand, everywhere else they go to.
Absolutely. In my book, they are the most dominant tag team in pro wrestling tonight.
Bold statement.
Detroit, Michigan, Benjamin Chimera!
Hey,
Ladies and gentlemen, Chimera's opponents in the gauntlet match. First, Van Rear. Three bunnies in the back of my Cadillac. The Dark Horse, Avery Hearst. Johnny Cisco. The side piece, Bryant Khan.
Folks, we're back here at Geek. We got Heat. Bryce T joined by... Hello, JC.
It's great to be here. JC Flash and Ringside. About to go into this gauntlet match, Bryce.
Indeed. As the rule states, Vent Chimera will be first in against Fenrir, it looks like. Chimera is looking to put all four of the graduating class down. We're starting off with the man who wants to bring Ragnarok himself. JC, the past couple of weeks, it's been a bit of a dysfunction at the junction for the graduating class. We saw it even in their entrance. All four of them.
You know, they have the opportunity right now. They have the opportunity right now, right at this moment, to make Benjamin Coming Chimera eat his words on one of the biggest shows of the year, and we'll see what they do with that opportunity.
That we will. Cover there by Fenrir. Only a one count. Last week we saw...
Cover! Fenrir with that near fall. Benjamin Chimera making his way back to his feet.
Sent Fenrir into the ring post and now scooping him up.
Oh, and look at that. Drop down. Chimera.
Oh, and there's a tap out by Fenrir. Chimera letting it go.
Ladies and gentlemen, Fenrir eliminated from the gauntlet match.
It looks like Johnny Cisco is up next.
See what Johnny Cisco can do. Look at the drop kick.
All four of these men going into this week said each one of them had their own reasons for wanting to put Chimera out. Each one wants to be the man to do it. Fenrir was not successful, but Cisco's looking to end this at two.
Oh, look at that. Double knees to the face. Chimera goes down to one knee.
Cisco now. Looks like he's going to climb to the top. The almighty definitely dazed.
Johnny said, no, Chimera. The veteran Chimera, Bryce. Did you see that?
Using the ropes to his advantage, knocking the balance of Cisco off. And now.
The waist lock takedown. Putting all that body weight on top of Johnny Cisco.
Johnny Cisco eliminated from the gauntlet match.
Some kind of submission maneuver. Hard to tell what that was from this angle.
Yeah, we don't have a good angle for that, but either way, that is two men down. The Chimera is taken out with a submission move, but here comes Avery, running knee.
Now, Chimera, he's dropping these guys like flies, but you can see that it's taking its toll. Chimera toppling over. Avery Hearst looking to bring the hurt to Chimera.
Chimera up to his feet.
Combination of kicks. Over the ropes comes Avery. Beautifully done. Shining wizard right to the face.
Avery now waiting for Chimera to get back up again. But he's caught.
Tornado DDT.
Great maneuvering there by Avery. Who he said Chimera made it personal after what he did to him in their singles match.
Avery trying to climb his way to the top, He does. And there's a splash. Nobody home. No water in the pool, Bryce.
And here we see Avery clutching at the knee. The same knee that Chimera had gone and dismantled before. Bryant checking on Avery there, seeing if he's okay. I don't think Avery's going to be getting up at all, JC.
That knee. You know, it's been compromised in the past. Benjamin Chimera looking like he might finish it off for good. Look at that, bigger four leg lock. The power of Benjamin Chimera. Those powerful legs. Avery's got a tap.
Is it? He's trying to hold on, and he does.
Avery Hertz has been eliminated from the
combat.
Three
of the graduates down, leaving only Bryant
Huff
left.
Huff remains.
Bryant Huff is the last man of the graduates who has not had a singles match against Chimera, but I know he still has all the reason to make this personal. You see him wearing those purple tights. Those are the same tights he wore in his first ever professional wrestling match. And then at the end of that match, it was Chimera who came and interfered, ruining his dream of his debut. So he wants to get revenge here tonight.
Huff's been waiting a long time for this. Exchanging right hands with Benjamin Chimera. Chimera definitely has the power advantage. But Bryant Huff, he has the
aptitude. He has the athleticism.
He also has the advantage of the fact that Chimera has already competed against three other people. Oh, look at that flying knee.
Huff off to a great start in his leg of this race.
Flying knee right to the face. Benjamin Chimera being brought back to his feet. Put in the corner by Bryant Huff. Clothesline. Oh, beautiful Pele kick. Chimera's still on his feet, though. Oh, maybe not.
Falling like a giant redwood in a forest.
It definitely made a sound.
And now Huff going up top. Definitely a good chance.
Chimera's not moving.
Still no sign of moving here. Huff in position.
Wow! Twisted punishment! Corkscrew sets on, what a move!
But it wasn't enough! JC, the fact that that didn't put Chimera away is astounding.
That was a very impressive move by Bryant Huff, and Bryce, you're right, that corkscrew, all of his body weight coming down on top of Chimera. Chimera able to kick out. What's Bryant Huff gonna do next?
Goes in with that forearm, trying to whip the Almighty.
Hey, look at this! Makata Hajime! That right. Choke!
He has it in tight. But will Chimera tap? Will he follow the way of the other three?
I think Chimera's fading. Bryant Huff, he might pull this off.
His arm, it's drooping lower and lower with each passing second.
Huff being backed up into the corner by Chimera.
Bryant has to release the hold, though. He doesn't want to get disqualified. Oh!
That's one way to release the hold and not get disqualified with the referee's back turned.
There was the Huff kick there. It definitely does not look pretty for Huff.
Bryce, you got to give your kudos to Benjamin Chimera for that.
That's that veteran awareness.
I think he's going for that Texas Cloverleaf. Bryant Huff is in trouble. Has he just gone through? Has Chimera just gone through the entire graduating class?
Will Huff hold on? He's trying. He's reaching out for the ropes, but right now he can't claw anywhere,
no
and he does.
No
Ladies and
out.
Gentlemen, the winner
out.
Of the gauntlet match, Benjamin Chimera.
It was a valiant effort displayed by all four members of the graduating class, but in the end, the Almighty reign supreme.
Absolutely incredible. At 58 years old, Benjamin Chimera runs right through. I'm gonna say he ran right through. You know, these guys, they gave everything they had to win Chimera, but somehow, he, oh, wait a minute.
Oh, no.
Look at this, Chimera's got a chair.
He said a while ago that this has gone beyond teaching a lesson, that this is just pure anger with them at this point. But now the graduates coming out to save their friend.
Let's hope they work together better than they did.
And there we see
that battle royal.
Their friend Killinger coming out as well. They all got weapons against him. Chimera. What? Hey. No, Killinger.
What? Oh.
The fifth graduate who had trained alongside all four of these men, having turned their backs, and as he joined the forces with Benjamin.
I mean, it looks that way. It looks like that's exactly what's happening here.
JC, I can't believe what I'm seeing right before my eyes.
Papa powerbomb.
And Huff is just out near cold after that. And now Chimera throwing Cisco to Killinger.
Killinger and Chimera using the element of surprise to its outright most effectiveness price. Oh no. Oh, Chimera.
Attacking the leg and the side.
He's got a little bit too far.
He's outright. He just bent the chair off the bones and body of Cisco.
Bryce, this damn well better. This might be the night that Chimera fulfills his prophecy, that he does what he says he's going to do and puts all of these guys out tonight. And we got heat.
Might just be with the assistance of Killinger alongside of him. The fifth graduate, the man who saw his friends go on, finish their duty earlier than he did. It was an injury that put him away, and now I think it's the jealousy that's fueling his power, making him side with Chimera. And now, right in front of Fenrir's own mother, Chimera just broke Fenrir's arm.
Oh my, you know, part of me doesn't mind seeing this after what they did to me in that battle royal. But at the same time, these are human beings.
Chimera.
He may be very well be destroying the future of FGW right now in front of us, Bryce.
That's exactly what he said he would do. He would take out the future and that he would burn this company to the ground.
Along with Killinger.
And these two, oh no.
Y'all forgot one very important thing about a god. He always has disciples. We've settled for good and all that you don't belong in this business. None of you do. Pack your bags, go home. Fenrir, have your mom tuck you in, take you home. Because the Chimera era of the Almighty is just beginning.
Sickening actions here by Chimera and Killinger.
But what a statement that they made.
That they have. Folks, we're going to make sure we have medical attention for the graduates. We'll be back under a short commercial break with more We Got Heat.
To watch over again. But, you know, I took those lessons from those matches and I ran with them. I continue to fight bigger opponents. I have a great tag match with Roach, or against Roach, rather, with my buddy MVP that you're about to see here. Fun little teaser for the future that involves the Bosom Buddies connection. And also, you know, I wanted to include something a little bit different from what I typically do, which is get smashed by giant humans. So I wanted to show you that there is a difference between getting your face stomped in by a demon man and having yourself folded in half as many times as possible in 5 minutes by Pompano Joe. Two of my favorite matches. I distinctly remember, despite how tired I was, that the entire FGW crowd cheered me back up to my feet after my match against Roach. So I wanted to thank you all for that. That's something that I will never forget. Enjoy these next two matches, and I got one more big one at the end for you.
This is Hook, the heavy metal Viking and hardcore legend, and you are watching FGW Shockwave.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please welcome my guest. He's from the other side of the tracks, Johnny Cisco!
All right, I promised you I was going to have a lot to say this week, and I'm going to say it all really loudly. I came out.
Position right now. He's ready to use that microphone if he has to.
He's keeping his eyes open.
Let the people hear what you have to say.
I came out here last week saying I was sick and tired of people like you bullying me, thinking I'm an easy win for you guys. And apparently it takes both of you to come out here and scare me. So, No, you know, but you definitely tried your best, didn't you?
When the sun rises, I wake up and chase my dreams. I won't regret.
Want somebody to come on out to even some of the size odds here, Cisco? Well.
Oh, I love this song, Bryce.
Of course you do.
I'm a mother. Why get back to make you run around again like it's a fire? I spit acid tips like I got cyanide in my saliva. Watch me wet and heat and shove like I'm a washer and a dryer. Will I beat you in your head until you tired?
I'm a mother.
See the baby got a money getting his open. I'm doing it again, tripping it on skate. Got a fucking wallet like in the ball pit. Look at me wishing it had to be hoping. That I would have managed and I stop and I will finish when I drop. I always kill it in the hotter than a skillet. Thinking what I'm with the guard, you gotta be joking.
Every single time.
I've been all around the back, and it doesn't seem like 5MW's here anywhere. So my partner's not here because of those guys. And, you know, I see you two out here. And Cisco here is a Hawk Army member like I am. So, you know, I'm thinking no 5MW, but Bosom Buddies... We don't throw things up, but we're always ready to throw down. So I'm thinking, Cisco, Hawk Army, man. I think I got your back on these Roach Boys.
Oh, did you hear that, Nicole?
Oh, yeah. As Cisco looked like he needed some help.
Cisco, I know he likes standing on his own 2 feet, but definitely having someone in your corner, especially someone like MVP, always a nice service to have. And now we got a tag match on our hands, Nicole.
Heck yeah, and it's going to be one heck of one.
Steve will immediately taunt back at Cisco. He talks with his brother, Brian Wild. Well, the crowd clearly are glad to see MVP. Steeble, though, still mocking the two of them.
I don't think Roach came here to play. I think Roach came here to devour tonight.
Anyone? Saw Steeble go and swipe at Cisco's face there. Pete just waiting for Steeble to come on, trying to throw an attack at him.
Oh, you hear Brian. He says the louder you cheer, the more he's going to beat on him.
Well, Steeble nearly got rolled up there. And that really upset at Ryan Wild.
I think that crowd got to them.
I wouldn't be shocked if that was the case. MVP, he has a smile on his face. Steeble, looking menacing as ever, though. Looks like he's leaking black ooze out of his mouth.
It's hard for me to pay attention with that bright jersey MVP's wearing tonight. Jeez. Uh-oh.
Oh, Pete, tuck out the way of the clothesline now.
I thought he was going to get one of Steeble's chops there for a second.
Tag into Cisco. Steeble, this is what you wanted.
There
Cisco
you go.
Trying to club away at the back, but oh, getting shoved back by Steeble.
I'll tell you what, Cisco definitely has some heart. He's somebody you definitely want to have in your corner.
Steeble letting Cisco get a punch in there. It looked like it did some damage. Steeble shook it off, but he's rocking him a little bit.
Oh, he is. It's not doing much to Steeble, but he can take a lot. Steeble's a monster. We all know that.
Try going for that pulling forearm. And oh, Steeble just licked him.
Ah.
Right on the eye, too. That's disgusting.
That was but that's just Steeble we're talking about. Poor Cisco had to tag in. Look at
It's all across his face now.
I know. I like the war paint. It actually looks pretty cool. I don't know why.
Looking like he's one of the people from Avatar.
See? Yes. Okay. It's going to take a minute for him to be able to see.
Oh, yeah. He's going to test his strength there and said opting not to go for that. MVP knocking Steeble back into the corner. Comes in hot.
He's not done yet. Oh, yes. Cisco looks like he's going up, right?
Yep. Dropping the hammer down on the arm of Steeble. Nice uppercut there. And another forearm strike to the face. Another one. Third time the charm, but Steeble. Telling Cisco to bring it through the legs. Steeble looks confused.
He does. Oh, Cisco on the back.
There you see, trying to put, got the sleeper hold in.
Put him to sleep.
That smack across the back.
That was not right.
Oh, spun off the back of Steeble.
Brian Wild is not done. He is just having some fun now. Oh my God! Oh, I just heard that was. Oh.
My own soul just left my body. MVP trying to go get in. Wild pushed him off the apron.
It's not good.
Look at that, Bryce. Nasty tactics here from Roach. Living up to their villainous name. steal there. Come on, Cisco! Saw him laugh for a second as Ryan Wild now takes Cisco, lifts him up for a vertical suplex.
Oh, did you see that ring? It all shook.
But Cisco actually kicking out.
Ah, Cisco, I told you, the big heart in that man.
The crowd believe in Cisco. You hear those cheers, those whistles, those claps.
Listen to that chant. I love that.
The crowd's got a rhythm to it, but right now Steele not paying any mind because there's the cannonball.
Oh, Cisco just crumbles to the floor, motionless. He ain't got a soul in his body after that one, Bryce. You said it yourself.
And now Steeble, who just take by the legs, slingshotting Cisco, catapulting him into that bottom rope.
Oh, his throw, and Ryan Wild's not done with them either.
And look at that, choking out Cisco. And now.
Oh, what's he gonna do, Bryce?
Extra force behind that kick to the sternum there, Cisco.
Oh, Cisco, he's still got a little life left in his body.
We saw before in his match with Jake Sheppard, Cisco can take a lot of a beating, but there comes a point when you're in a situation like this that you are just caught for the worst, and Steeble giving a headbutt down low.
Poor Cisco, not even going to get a chance to enjoy the rest.
Pressing his boot into the back of the neck of Cisco. Now Ryan Wild picking up where Steeble left off.
Oh, no, he's going to surf, Bryce. That's rough.
That is hundreds of pounds of pure monster man being crushed into your back. Not what you want to have feeling, that's for certain. Shoulder pressing in the corner there. Steve will tag himself in.
Uh-oh, watch out, Joe.
Forearm straight across the face there. K.O. You heard Ryan Wild jokingly saying K.O., knockout. But Cisco.
He's getting up.
Somehow, some way, he's finding the power in himself to get back up to his feet and bring the fight to Steve.
He is a crazy animal, I'm telling ya.
Oh, he tried going
in. Oh, no.
But Steeble, he caught that crossbody. And now look at this. Fall away slam there from Steeble. He trying to argue with referee Joe Copas as Ryan Wild now. Right back in. Oh, stretching out the chest.
We know what that means. Oh, yes. No.
Chop. Now anvil elbows. Cisco just caught there. Nowhere to go.
He's still hanging on, though. There's still life. Oh, Cisco reaching for that tag.
But Wild kept him holding by the hair. Now goes straight in the boot of Steeble. Tag into the heretic.
They don't look clean.
Roach right now being absolutely disastrous to the well-being of Cisco here.
That was rough sounding. Oh my God. I wouldn't be able to get up after. I don't feel bad for Cisco right now.
I feel like
stay
I.
Stay down.
I feel like I heard his spine crack from here off that. Tag back into Ryan Wild. Cisco still, though, he's on his feet, double whip into the ropes. He comes in running. And there we see landing on his feet. Back in, but wait.
Oh, Joe didn't see it.
No, he didn't. He was too busy looking at Roach that he missed the tag. Cisco's trying to tell him. It's like, no, we tagged. And we saw it with our eyes.
We saw all of it.
And now Going up, round two, here we go.
Oh!
Cisco is caught there. And now.
Uh-oh. Nope.
Oh,
no, he's
gosh.
Not done. They're not going to be lenient on him. Ah! Joe!
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of this match, Ryan Wild, Steve Hall, Rhodes.
Rhodes managed to get the victory here tonight over Keith Cisco, but it was certainly not between them the victory.
It wasn't, but to them it's still a victory, but like I said, Cisco
showed a lot of heart. Rhodes, meanwhile, getting a victory going into that tag team rumble next week and on the Wrong Turn, October 7th. Looking to become four-time FCW Tag Team Champion. And now look at him. Crossing. And standing in the crowd.
Squares as your eyes to save your life. The reality to make it real. Left focused on from Johnny's healing eyes. To know what's been done.
Offering a hand to Cisco, but it looks like Cisco's. It looks like he's refusing. He wanted to get up on his own two feet. A round of applause to Cisco for managing to stand back up on his own there.
Oh, most definitely. This man is looking better and better every time we see him in this arena. And I'm telling you, you're going to remember his name.
Indeed. But, folks, we'll be back with more wrestling action right after this commercial break. We'll see you in a second.
Who's everyone's homie? And who's watching Shockwave right now?
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first. From Pompano Beach, Florida, he is everyone's homie, Pompano
as always by Nicole Delisle here for another episode of Shockwave.
Oh, and another episode of our Catch Me If You Can series with Pompano Joe, Bryce.
Indeed, Pompano Joe last week at Wrong Turn introduced the Catch Me If You Can series. For those unaware, it is 3 5-minute rounds, accelerated 10 count, no punches or kicks, one warning allotted. Very traditional, kind of British round style match. And tonight, accepting the challenge was none other than Johnny Cisco. And Cisco floating back over towards the head, locking Pompano down, but Pompano standing right back up.
Hey, I think Cisco is a great match, a great competitor for this time around with Pompano Joe because, I mean, he reminds me a lot of Pompano. I think he's going to be able to hold it down. So Pompano has his work cut out for him tonight.
Johnny Cisco, in the past few weeks, he's accepted any challenge that's come his way.
Yes.
Faced a lot of the much larger competitors here during his FGW career thus far. And now he's wanting to continue on, proving that he's, after taking a week to heal back up, he's back at 100% and willing to take on a master technician in the likes of Pompano Joe. He's here to prove something.
Oh, yeah, I love it how you said master technician, because that's definitely what he is. There's no other words to describe Pompano. But Cisco, he's just making his way up. That man has got some heart. And he gives in there. He gets in that ring. It doesn't matter who he's with. And he gives it his all. He is an absolute fighter.
That he absolutely is. Also, I do want to make a side note. As you see, referee Steve wearing the pink and black stripes here in honor of Breast Cancer Awareness Month. I know many people are personally affected by that issue every time of the year.
Yes.
We here at FGW put our condolences out for anyone who's afflicted by that. Please, if you have any availability, there's plenty of charitable donations for you to go. The Breast Cancer Society of America, for instance, is a great donation source. And we here are glad to be able to help bring awareness.
1 minute remains in round number one.
Yes, perfect, perfect. Oh, you know what's not very perfect? The position that Cisco is put in right now by Pompano Joe.
See, but Johnny Cisco, he's trying to chop his lay on out of it, but Pompano delivering it right on back. You also heard the 1 minute warning there, meaning that now less than 60 seconds until round one of three expires. Both men going for a lockup once again. Cisco takes control of the wrist. Pompano rolls through, swings the leg, cover.
Send the cover. Oh no, Cisco was real quick on that one.
Yeah, both men kicking out rather quickly. They're going for it right now. They're accelerated pace, trying to finish this up. Throw him back down. Pompano tries to take control, but Cisco rolls on out.
Hey, they're definitely dancing right now, Brian.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes round one. We have two more rounds scheduled in this Catch Me If You Can series.
Now that you heard that bell, round one has expired. There's now a 30-second break in between.
That didn't sound like 30 seconds. Oh, well, no wonder.
Yeah, because look who it is.
Oh, he's got his, come on.
Jake Shepard coming out here with his smart corn and
he just wants to watch.
Expensive Essentia water.
Yeah, yep, nice popcorn. It's the smart popcorn.
Johnny Cisco, one of the men that he faced what so far thus is Jake Shepard. Those two had one heck of a war. Jake Shepard. Donnie knocked him out for good, but Cisco came right on back. And now here he is, using that rope to flip himself out of the grasp there of Pompano Joe. Both these men trading holes back and forth. Neither one did able to take control for long, but oh, the strength of Pompano Joe!
Cisco's just hanging on. He better hang on or break that arm.
That landing on the shoulder didn't do it first. And there you see Pompano using his boots, trying to pull the arm out of socket right now, trying to make Cisco tap out.
Oh, poor Cisco just gets tossed.
But you saw what he did there. He tried pushing some force back down into Pompano, trying to get the shoulders down. Didn't work out for a three count, but these two continue at it once again.
Oh my gosh, Bryce.
And Pompano, once again, taking control of that arm, but Cisco grabbed the hold of the rope.
He got that rope.
And Nicole, you have to wonder, what might be going through Johnny Cisco's mind right now, now that Jake Shepard's come out here to get an up close and personal seat for this.
We have 1 minute left in round number two.
Just keep swimming, just keep swimming.
Can't keep your mind off the ball as he goes to the roll, but oh, still, again, only a two. Once again, less than 30 seconds, or less than a minute left.
Is that roll up?
Taking opportunity after opportunity, both these men doing everything they can to catch the other if they can.
Yes.
Trying to get the surprise
on. Exactly.
Sort of the name of the game.
Yeah. And a great movie. Just want to point that out.
I haven't seen it. Then again, I haven't seen that.
Ah, switching it up.
Oh, each of these chops getting progressively more and more painful. And just on the outside there, you see Jake Shepard just nodding his head too. Popping up. Let's try Cisco, but up and over goes Cisco. Comes in. Ducks all right. Ducks another. Oh, but caught. Turns it back around. Oh, I thought it was.
Man.
He was trying to go for a DDT there, but there's the one, two, three.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time has run out on round number two. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Pompano Joe.
Pompano Joe there getting the victory there in the literal last second of the round.
Oh, like last second.
Yeah, I was with Tom's there for a second. I thought the time limit had expired, but nope. Lo and behold, Pompano Joe came to secure that pinfall just in the nick of time.
And you see Cisco right now. I think he looks like he's a little shocked because that was definitely a shocker.
And there you see Jake Shepard just clapping, shaking his head mockingly.
I don't trust Jake Shepard.
I certainly don't either. But folks, stay tuned. We have more Shockwave to come after this commercial break.
One other thing you'll probably notice in this match is partway through when Jake goes to smash me into a post, I manage to escape, but unfortunately not unharmed. I fall down clutching my knee and I was able to finish the match. I won't spoil the ending for you, but long term, unfortunately, I found out that my ACL is not. The doctor gave me a picture of the inside of my knee and wrote no ACL on the bottom. I had my surgery back in April, a few months in. I'm walking again without a brace, thankfully. But unfortunately, I'm now on the very long, very boring part of my recovery, which is standing around, watching all my friends wrestle, and waiting for my turn again. So I'm very thankful for this opportunity to kind of share some of my favorite matches from this first year with you. Thank you all for coming to watch, and make sure you keep tuning in to see some of the rest of your favorite wrestlers show off some of their favorite matches, because if you liked what I had to show you, those other more talented guys who've been around for half a decade or more, they're going to have some crazy stuff to show you. So make sure you show up.
Winner takes all in this situation.
I'm telling you, I'm a big fan of Johnny Cisco. He's like a crazy spider monkey. He's going to be all over Big Jake Shepard. He better keep his eyes open because that man's spunky.
As you see right now, Big Jake Shepard driving Cisco into the turnbuckle. Cisco trying to deliver some elbows, but Shepard just, oh, giant knee to the, oh, and it just pundling to his back. Oh. Whips him off the ropes. Here he goes. He ducks that clothesline.
Ducks it. Goes right
there. Goes around him. What's happening here? Cisco trying to figure something out.
Oh, Cisco is a straight-up brawler. He's got a lot in his back pocket that he's going to bring tonight. Oh, but we all know Big Jake Shepard has been the man for a long time now. I'm definitely not counting him out because this is really hard when you like two wrestlers so much, even though we're not supposed to, but, you know. You know, I do what I want, and I love both these guys.
Just to give you a little history lesson, these guys have been going at it since before Wrong Turn, all the way back in October, and now we're just now finally getting to the conclusion of these two, finally getting a piece of each other. Oh, Cisco, oh, drops him down on the throat, right on that top rope.
This is the match right here that you're going to remember from March to the future. part two. This is the one that might end up being on your favorite match of 2023.
Right there, you saw Cisco utilizing his speed, coming off that top rope with a beautiful double with a missile drop kick. But right there, you see Jake Shepherd just instantly right back on it by just delivering the thunderous right hands.
Oh, and man, for Cisco to have that big foot on his chest, that's not good stuff.
The one thing, Nicole, that you're going to have to realize here is that we don't honestly know if Cisco is actually 100%.
Yeah.
For the last 6 months now, Jake Shepherd has punished Cisco. He's hurt every bone in his body. And right now, Cisco, as you can see with that heavily braced right knee, has absolutely maybe not 110% coming into this match.
Yeah, Cisco is definitely a fighter. He's a behind-the-bar street fighter, if you ask me. And hopefully he's going to bring some of that tonight on Big Jake Shepherd.
As you see right there, he tried to jump on Jake Shepherd's back, trying to put him in some type of a sleeper hold. But Jake Shepherd just throws him off. But now Cisco back on attack. Got Jake Shepherd leaning on that top rope.
Oh. Oh, he was ready for Cisco. I don't think Cisco was ready for that one, though. God. And Cisco always takes a beating, but you cannot keep him down. Oh, but that step to the chest from Big Jake Shepherd might be the ending stomp that keeps Cisco down.
If my calculations are correct, all 245 pounds stepping on Cisco's chest probably will probably do the trick, but Cisco is up. He ducks out of the way. Oh, he drop kicks a chair right into Jake's head.
Hey, this is last man standing. Who's going to be the last man? I'm not so sure. Not between these two animals. Big Jake Shepherd just got rocked by the chair. He was one to use on Cisco, and Cisco turns it around and uses it on him.
Did you see right there, Big Jake Shepherd was not expecting Cisco to have this type of fire up. He hits him again. He's hitting him in that midsection. Oh, another big shot to the midsection. He finally took the big man off his feet. What is Cisco doing here? Oh, there's no way he's going coast to coast, Nicole.
Oh, my gosh. But this, oh, man. He's like a flying squirrel. Look at that.
Oh, my God. He just went coast to coast on Big Jake Shepherd.
Oh, man. I told you, Steve, one of the best matches so far of the year. That's what this is going to be. Cisco just shows you how much a phenomenal athlete he is. You can beat him and beat him down, but he's getting right back up on that top rope.
Like I said, he is the fighting spirit here at FGW.
Yes.
It takes a lot to get him down. It takes a lot to keep him down. And Big Jake Shepherd's actually finding that out right now. As Jake had to step out of the ring for just a minute, maybe catch a little, coaching there by Russell. But you see Cisco, though, he just slingshots himself over. But
oh, no, he got caught, Steve. Oh, God, this ain't good.
Oh, Cisco pushing him right into that ring post.
Oh, these guys are down.
Oh, wait a minute. That's the knee we were talking about. We see Cisco holding it.
This is not good, Steve. Not good at all. But you see Cisco, he gets himself back up.
Cisco's back in the ring. We see Russell, he's out there sneaking around. He's got to get up.
Big Jake Shepherd's pulling himself up. Last
man up
standing,
yet?
Though. This is last man standing. You hear that count?
He stood up and he fell down, so now the ref has to start the count all over again.
Jake Shepherd, he is bleeding.
We got blood, Nicole.
Oh. It's not an FGW night until somebody's bleeding from the head.
Right now, you see Cisco. He's going to have to be like a shark in the water.
Oh, it's not good, Steve. Not good at all.
Oh, Cisco's got him in. Oh.
Oh, he's stuck.
He's got him trapped.
Oh, yeah.
This is Cisco's time to shine.
Keep going. Don't. Oh. Oh, and a port.
Oh. We just saw Russell act a fool, come in and hit him with that baseball bat.
Oh, but here comes the Bosom Boys.
Here's the Bosom Boys.
Coming out.
They're going to equal the playing field here.
There he goes. Russell, he's like a spunky chinchilla.
This is it. The Bosom Boys right now. Gigi in hot pursuit. Gigi, what happened to Gigi?
I don't know. But I see what's going on in the middle of this ring. Oh, it's still got taken down.
Big Jake Shepherd is leaking everywhere.
Oh, God. It is terrible. Oh, Cisco is hanging on. Big Jake Shepherd is in a world of hurt right now. Still last man standing. I want to point that out. Both these guys are still going strong, Steve.
Yeah, Cisco's got that fight, but look at Jake Shepherd. He is gushing blood everywhere.
Oh, it's going to be hard to hang on to this big man.
Here he goes. He's got him in that sleeper. Oh, my God. He finally gets him down.
Oh.
But no, so is Cisco.
The last.
Look at the amount of blood that's all over the mat.
I'm glad I don't have to clean that up.
Jake Shepherd is gushing blood. And did Cisco finally do the damage he needed to keep him down as Cisco's making his way to his feet? Cisco is up.
Oh!
Cisco wins.
Yeah, there's that bell. Last man standing is Johnny.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Cisco.
The winner of the last man standing.
This is the answer that he's been waiting for. He
Johnny
finally takes it to Big
Cisco.
Jake. Johnny Cisco, ladies and gentlemen, wins the last man standing.
Oh, man, what a fight. What a knockdown, drag out brawl. Like I said, one of the best matches of 2023, in my own opinion. Go Johnny Cisco.
Johnny Cisco with a little bit of help from the Bosom Boys. But look at Jake Shepherd. He is left dead center in that ring, and he's still gushing blood. Well, Nicole, we're going to take it to a commercial break, and we'll be back right after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am the ultimate wingman, Russell Actor Fool Bland. He is the quintessential male, Big Jake Shepherd. We are the Marquee Players. Welcome to the Marquee Players Club.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next match is an anything goes hardcore match.
We been sending shots and talking about pivot. Hit you in the face, Olivia and jaw twitching. I get in the ring and go get it. I get in the ring and go get it. I get in the ring and go get it. I get in the ring and go get it. Chasing that bag, I'm stacking up all digits. Climb to success, I'm hoping I fall in it. Things I do in the ring is called gifted. And I'm gonna grind as long as the Lord give it. I get in the ring and go get it. I get in the ring and go get it. I get in the ring and go get it. I get in the ring and go get it. Yeah, my boy Russell, all about the hustle. You don't wanna tussle, arm full of muscle. And my boy Jake, he ain't never fake. You don't wanna play, hit you in the face. I get in the ring and go get it. I get in the ring and go get it.
Cut the music, cause it's time to get down to business. I ain't finna waste no time telling y'all how much I hate being in this city. It sucks. So right now, I'ma get down to it. This ain't gonna be no normal intro. Y'all know who he is. Y'all know who I am. Y'all know who he is. Bring out the next opponents so we can handle business.
Yeah.
JC, are you ready to get hardcore?
I'm always ready.
I know you have a bit of history in that stipulation.
Absolutely. We've already seen some hardcore action earlier tonight, actually just now, at the Illuminati card shop. But this match, Tornado Tag Hardcore Tag Team Contest.
It was last week. Jake Shepherd threw down the challenge to Cisco and Ganger, saying that they thought that he couldn't get hardcore. Well, he can get hardcore. But right now, I think they're going to make him regret that decision.
Ganger, Cisco, as you said, both taking it to Jake Shepherd. Silva creeping his way back into the ring. Ganger catching wind of that.
Jay Silva, quite literally the only person that we know who is willing to stand alongside Jake Shepherd. I don't know why he keeps doing it.
And here's Ganger tossing Johnny Cisco into a chair, into Jake Shepherd, and that side across the back of Ganger.
Silva now slugging away at Cisco.
Those right hands rocket Cisco back into the corner.
Knocking him up. And now Silva asking for the sign again. Laying it on the ground. I don't like where this is going.
Oh, spinning complete shot.
Now Ganger, though, with a sign available.
Silva, you might want to turn around.
Silva.
Oh! You're caught in two-way traffic.
What? Was that? Was that a super kick from Jake Shepherd?
Like watching an old Yokozuna match. Woo! Oh.
Oh, taking off the belt.
So much malice behind that shot to the back, that strap to the back.
But Russell Actifool Bland coming in with the marquee money. It's a hardcore match. There's nothing saying he can't do it. But on the floor, oh my gosh, JC.
Hold on. He just rocked the one true legend right in the skull.
Yeah, but also on the floor, I'm pretty sure Jay Silva just got cut open with a pizza cutter.
Hard to keep up with all this action. Hopefully our arena can maintain this hardcore tag team match.
And now we're back to where it all began as Jake Shepherd trying to crush Johnny Cisco on the bottom rope. Jake Shepherd, for about 6 months now, half a whole year, has been hunting, demolishing, trying to break down Johnny Cisco's body. Cisco, he views as just a nuisance, a spite to his own being, because Cisco never goes down. And it's that determination, that spirit, that has caused Jake Shepherd to be incensed with trying to end Johnny Cisco.
Oh, no!
But
a hockey stick across the spine, perpendicular to the backbone.
The man from Michigan, Jay Silva, taking that hockey stick and trying to choke Cisco out with it. Cisco, though, using his momentum to knock Silva to the floor.
That's a fork in the hands of Ganger.
Oh, gosh.
And if you remember Maximum Mayhem from last year, then you will know that Ganger knows a thing or two about hardcore wrestling.
Ganger, not just a legend here.
Christ, he just stabbed Jake Shepherd in the head repeatedly.
He did.
In the middle of the ring, that's sanctioned under these rules in this environment.
And these guys can get away with just about anything short of actually killing somebody.
And again, right to the head of Jake Shepherd.
Jake Shepherd is out and down, and Ganger, you see he has some blood spitting himself, but he ain't quitting. But now you see the crimson cascading down Shepherd's face. Oh, hell is breaking loose in the ring, out of the ring. Ganger with a side to the back of Jake Sheppard. The quintessential male feeling the wrath of the former number one contender for the FGW Championship.
Jake Sheppard, I saw in the camera there for a second. He got glassy-eyed. And as Cisco right now, beating away on Silva on the floor still.
What's this?
Oh, no. Not Tax.
And much to the line of these bloodthirsty FGW fans as Ganger pour those Tax right in the middle of the room. Ganger's incensed.
Oh, but Sheppard, he regained his consciousness here.
Oh, the Pitbull's in trouble. Ganger in a vulnerable position.
Sheppard about to show him why you should.
Oh, no!
Oh, a low blow!
Completely legal! Completely legal! Look at this!
Now he's in the shoulder!
And Ganger took those tacks to his back.
I don't think Ganger was fully thinking through where his positioning was. He just set himself straight into them tacks, and now you saw his back is glittering gold.
Bryce, these matches, they get messy. Oh my, Cisco. Perhaps knocked unconscious just that we have Jake Sheppard down on the ground being tended to by Russell Bland.
As Cisco rolls Silva back inside the ring. Ganger and Cisco.
The cover!
The cover. Two, three! They did it!
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of this match, Pitbull Ganger! And Johnny Cisco!
Johnny Cisco managed to knock Jay Silva unconscious just long enough to roll him in the ring and get him down to the ring.
Mike, hold on a second, it's not over.
We're going for a victory lap.
Jake Sheppard is. He lost his bet.
I gotta tell the people to stay tuned.
Very good,
it's
Jake Sheppard.
It's still gonna keep rolling. We'll be right back with more action.
Just say I'm the flyest man y'all have never seen in y'all life.
I'll take issue with that.
But anyway, let me get down to business. I'm talking to all of y'all, and I'm talking to y'all. It is my pleasure to introduce to y'all the rich woman's dream, poor woman's fantasy,
And there's a lot of poor women in here right now, so I know y'all all fantasizing. You might want to wipe the chairs down after they get up. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the quintessential male. Oh yeah, I forgot. Weighing in at a slim trim, 250 pounds. I might be, hey, 245, my bad. I might be heavier with all these chains on. Ladies and gentlemen. Big Jake Shepherd. We are the Marquee Players.
It's about to get heavy. He is accompanied to the ring by Johnny Cisco from Dayton, Ohio. Pitbull
JC, I want to let you know that this is us two right now. I'm just looking at Big Jake and my beard gets a little nervous, but I know you had your problems with Russell. I've had my problems with Big Jake, so.
I'll tell you who else's problems with Big Jake have erupted around here lately, and that is Johnny Cisco and Gager. Johnny Cisco injured recently by that man, and Gager.
Yes, right now Johnny Cisco is unable to compete, so Ganger is stepping in and taking his place for this match tonight.
Forearm smash. Both men fighting, throwing hands early on in this matchup.
You know, it only takes one move from Big Jake, but we're going to say that Ganger, he is unhinged.
Well, Gager, he's been in this game a long time, a very capable competitor. He's knocked Jake Shepherd loopy, who found his way on the outside of the ring. Doesn't even know where he is. Gager, keep in mind, it was not too long ago, he was competing for the FGW Championship against Jack Vaughn.
Yes. He just took a swing at Ross over there in the corner. That's how I think he knocked.
Ain't nobody sitting in now, boy. What is that?
Like,
talking about going over a game plan here. He's teaching Jake Shepherd how to bob and weave.
They do have a 10 count to their defense. Poor Jake Shepherd's got to step back in that ring, but he does indeed have to step in that ring with the pit bull if he is going to be victorious tonight against Gager one-on-one here at Cold Blooded.
No way, this is not, oh.
Going for an exploder suplex. Look at this now. Jake Shepherd going for something, maybe a urinagi?
Yeah, I don't know, but both men are like, now you're going to have to try a lot harder than that to get either one of them.
Oh, that was a flatliner. A two count.
A two count.
Bringing Jake Shepherd down, which is no easy task.
That's a whole lot of man trying to keep them shoulders pinned to the mat, JC.
And the one true legend in trouble in the corner. The pit bull with an overhand chop. Right to all that man meat, right to that chest.
Oh, my Lord. They're not even it's not even a slap. It is just a club. It's not even making the slap noise. It's just a solid club straight to the chest.
Outright impact, and now the pit bull showing just how pugnacious he can be.
Here, that's what I'm talking about, him being unhinged. He is just absolutely not all there sometimes.
Oh, my God. What a shotgun drop kick from the one true legend, Jake Shepherd.
Oh, there it is. Mr. 245.
He's the rich woman's dream. He's a poor woman's fantasy, and he might just be the victor of this match. He might be the one to take out Ganger at Cold Blood, and he might do it, Steve.
I'm telling you this right now. He's wasting too much time over here in the corner with Cisco. He's too busy worried about it. And he's letting, well, besides Russell over here in the corner, obviously Ref Josh didn't see it. But he was giving him a little too much time there.
Well, Jake Shepard looks like he's doing okay. Johnny Cisco inadvertently taking the ref's eyes off of the competition in the ring, allowing Jake Shepard some time to, well, introduce Ganger's throat to that rope.
Oh! You heard the connection on that one.
A nice sidekick there, right to the mouth.
Get back, guy! Get back! Hey, your
hand. Johnny Cisco.
Over here.
Intersecting himself in the mix.
Yeah, so much going on right now. We got action in the ring. We got action on the outside. See, this is what I'm talking about. Jake Shepard has this problem where he likes to waste too much time in between moves, where he wants his picture taken. He wants to pose in front of the camera. He wants to dance with Russ or whatever it may be. He gives his opponents all that time to kind of get their second wind.
And Ganger now using that second wind. Looks like he's breathing just fine with those rights and lefts to the midsection.
Now he went to just verbally choking him into the corner there.
Well, he got till count of five to do that. Nice thrust kick there from Jake Shepard.
We're seeing a lot of good footwork from Jake Shepard. And he just literally dropped a huge drop kick. Nice kick to the mouth over here in the corner.
Jake Shepard's lucky he didn't go through the ring when he pulled off a huge drop kick and a double axe handle smash right in the swole of the back. Referee Josh Patterson only with a two count. And now,
he's giving him the warning.
He definitely introduced his palm to the larynx of Ganger. Not the first time either.
It's only got to take one big elbow or maybe one big splash. See, just that split second of him talking about it, here it comes, and that's all it took.
Oh,
big running clothesline.
Cover. Ganger seems to think that maybe that should be three. Josh Patterson saying two.
Oh there's the eyes.
And there's been a lot of utilization of that five count this match. You guys want to watch themselves. Disqualification's got to just be right around the corner at this point.
I don't think Johnny Cisco understands the harm that he's actually doing for Ganger. He keeps distracting the ref, letting Jake Shepard get the upper hand.
That shows the inexperience of Johnny Cisco as Jake Shepard takes down Ganger again. Only got the two count. Once again, 1 second away from victory. Jake Shepard now having a conversation with Russell Bland about what to do next. And wait a minute, Johnny Cisco.
Now we're in a tug of war over the money. What's happening here?
Ganger!
Oh, the biggest back suplex you ever see. Just right when I said that Johnny Cisco's been doing more harm, he comes over and stops Russell from sliding the money case and helps Ganger get the 1-2-3 over Big Jake Shepard.
Ganger and Johnny Cisco starting the year off right. A big win for the Pitbull. It's about to get
heavy. You know this is far from over. Once that knee is 100% and Cisco's able to return to action, Jake is not going to let that slide.
Well, we'll find out what happens as time goes on right now. Take a short break, but as always,